Welcome back, everyone. Tonight we're going to take a look at Iowa's roads and find out just how bad they are.
KCCI Cynthia Fodor checked the Department of Transportation's long list of highways that need repairs. She shows us 8 of the worst in central Iowa.
Judy Sheehy dreads her drive to work every day from Adel down Hickman.
It gets horrible.
Through Waukee to the Casey's near I-35/80.
It gets backed up and everybody is just bumper to bumper to bumper all the way down.
The Iowa Department of Transportation agrees Hickman, or Highway 6, is one of the worst roads in central Iowa.
You're also getting development along that corridor. You know, there's a Lifetime Fitness going in right there. You already have J. Pilot, Menards is there, you have the auto dealer there. Now you put all of that right there, people are going to feel more traffic than they are.
The DOT can't keep up with all the development west of the metro, causing congestion.
It's the corridor significantly changing, so how do you add capacity to it?
North of here, number 2, Ryder Corner, where 141 from Grimes meets the interstate. Another nightmare for commuters.
Your car's waiting to get off, and you're almost at a standstill in the local system. That tells us that we need to make improvements.
DOT Director Paul Trombino blames pressure on the interstate system for the worst problem areas.
It's a cluster, that's for sure.
Number 3, the Oralabor Road Interchange in Ankeny.
Just gets a lot of traffic backed up, and there are a lot of crazy drivers actually sometimes.
Where traffic backs up for miles during peak periods.
It gets pretty terrible. You'll be going north on 35, and you'll see people backed up almost a Corporate Woods exit. To get on the Ankeny exit. It gets ridiculous.
Not just congestion, but conditions create the worst roads.
It's a little rough sometimes.
Number 4, Highway 69 from Ankeny to Ames is anything but a smooth ride.
I think it's just too bumpy. Too many cracks.
It's like riding on rumble strips mile after mile. You not only see these ruts, you hear their rhythm. Much like number 5, 415 from Ankeny to Polk City, cracked concrete, a neglected patch of pavement.
The DOT does have construction work set for many of these roads, but not anytime soon. They don't expect to hit 415 between Ankeny and Polk City for 4 more years.
You get off the beaten path, yeah, there's definitely some out there that need improvement.
A recent study showed 42% of our local and state maintained roads are in poor or mediocre condition. Others on the DOT list, number 6, U.S. 169 near Boone, number 7, Iowa 224 and 14 near Newton, and number 8, U.S. 20 west of Fort Dodge. But as lawmakers try to fill a $215 million annual gap for these projects, there's only so much funding to fix Iowa's worst roads.
There's not enough funds, ultimately, to do all of those projects. And so we will have to make some recommendations, and I would expect the commission will have to make some decisions about how you handle, you know, those issues, which I think are going to be very, very challenging.
From dealing with bumps to bumper traffic, Iowans will need to pack their patience as they get behind the wheel down the road. Cynthia Fodor, KCCI 8 News, Iowa's news leader.
And state lawmakers are discussing increasing the gasoline tax 10 cents over 3 years to help repair our aging roads and bridges.